My name is Roberto Chalela from the Respiratory Medicine Department at Hospital del Mar in Barcelona, and I'm going to introduce you our paper Bispectral Index in Hypercapnic Encephalopathy Associated with COPD Exacerbations, a pilot study. The exacerbation of COPD are acute situations that condition patients' prognosis and quality of life. When this exacerbation is severe, it can induce hypoventilation with hypercapnia, acidosis, and encephalopathy. The respiratory encephalopathy will produce neurological abnormalities that can include changes in the level of consciousness, such as psychomotor excitation, confusion, stupor, coma, and death. This impairment in the level of consciousness can compromise airway permeability and patient's life. In the other hand, the bispectral index signal, or BIS, is an objective tool composed by some electrodes placed on the scalp of the patients that transform the brain activity waves into a numerical value ranging from 0 to 100. This technique is widely used to assess the depth of anesthesia during surgical procedures. In our study, we decided to evaluate the utility of BIS in patients with severe COPD exacerbations that develop respiratory acidosis and encephalopathy during the treatment with non-invasive mechanical ventilation. We analyzed the relationships of the BIS signal with the most widely used clinical scales in sedation. At the time of inclusion, patients were monitored with the BIS device, and in parallel, three clinical scales, the Glasgow scale, the Ramsay Sedation Scale, and the Richmond Agitation Sedation Scale, were repeatedly used at admission during the first 6 hours of hospital stay, after the disappearance of the encephalopathy semiology, and finally 3 months after discharge. The BIS signal was recorded for a total of 588 minutes without local complications. All patients showed an initial BIS of 90 or less, with a median of 71, with an upward tendency through the hospitalization period, and normalization in the post-discharge follow-up. We observed a significant correlation between these values and those obtained with the three scales. The best linear adjustment was obtained with the Ramsay scale, with an R value of 0.757, followed by Glasgow scale, and a more modest relationship was shown with Richmond scale. A close relationship was observed with the different category defined by the Ramsay scales. Patients with very light encephalopathy or Ramsay 2 showed a BIS value of 92.2, whereas more advanced level of encephalopathy, like Ramsay 3, correspond to a BIS of 68.1, and deep encephalopathy, the Ramsay 4, with BIS values of 58.8, which is characteristic of sedation and deep sedation. In the post-discharge evaluation, the BIS value was 94.6. So we can conclude that this pilot study shows that determination of BIS can be useful to objectively assess the degree of hypercapnic encephalopathy in COPD exacerbations. Its correlation is good with the clinical scales, especially with the Ramsay scale. The BIS seems to adequately reflect the state of consciousness in patients with hypercapnic encephalopathy. This technique has no relevant drawbacks and may be useful in monitoring critical respiratory patients.